Catch and fly, and then sleep over it, get up. The same thing is repeated. This is what you should do if you're in the forces. You either become an admiral, just quit me. I'm very clear. In my life, it's a yes or a no. There's no maybe. In my dictionary, there is no maybe, no border. No depression, but sometimes depression comes, visits and goes. Because of loss of money, it happens. That's it, very clear. You either become an admiral or just simply quit Navy. So I chose a next option. Because as a short service officer, you can't become an admiral. There's no policy that will allow you to become an admiral. Next very important thing is very, very crucial. How many are willing to become entrepreneurs here? Raise hands. Bas. Nobody wants to be an entrepreneur. That's it.
Previous care.
I'm going to scare you with the next slide. Update you. That's how you've got to be inside your brain. You either become an entrepreneur or simply die. You're worthless. For people like me. Okay? For people like me,
it's too hard.
It's very harsh. You're very, very harsh. See, when you're very harsh, you're clear as to what you have to do. Then you get your mentors. And tell them, you need not just one mentor, you need at least 10 mentors to control you. Because you know your powers, you know your strength. Sometimes you don't know your strength. That's where the mentors will come and guide you. So that was the brainstorming thing which was happening between me. You either become an entrepreneur, just die. So I decided not to die. First time I decided to quit, the second I decided not to die. I'll become an entrepreneur because I love my life. And then there comes the Eureka moment. I started, this was when I was writing a business plan, my friend was taking a picture. So I looked very funny, that's okay. That was the only time I wore glasses because I had migraine. They said you have to wear glasses, otherwise you won't, it will come back. So I just wore for a year and that's it. That was we use glasses, that's it. Oh, it's come without even me telling it. He was mentioning you need to have a business plan. Guys, this chart I wrote in 2009. It is still, right now, on my table, every day I visit to my office, and sit in front of me, the glass ke niche or table ke upar, beech mein, this sheet is there. I had to scan it, so it may not be very clear, but I'll explain to you what it is and where we are today. 2010 is what we wanted to launch magazine. We launched Tennis India magazine. We launched, and that time we named Unmanned India Unmanned, but now the name of the magazine is Unmanned. It's still going on. So we want to do this. 2011, we want to do some charity work. That time I used to think charity will really help. But believe me, it's a very smart work. If you know how to use your CSR activities very smartly, you can make money. It's really smart. So I was more religious that time. I'm no more religious. So some, good, poor children, blah, 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 and all that. And then we want to get 2015, joint adventures. And then we want to start aeronautical hobbying, horse riding, paraglider, what all I used to think. And then 2020 was the time I wanted to start making drones, aeromodels, and aircraft. And 4 years ahead of time. I started manufacturing drones. Last year. And I see this every single day. I go onto my office and sit there. I see, first thing I see is, up kaha hai. You're studying, right? Go back and see your business plan. Nine, one page, and you see this every single day. It will keep telling you, it will keep booting you where you are and what you have to do. This is what I did. In 2009, I started working forward. And 2011 comes. That's it. Okay, the biggest trouble with entrepreneurs, or rather wannabe entrepreneurs, is when do I start? What to do? Kab karun? Is it going to work? It's not going to work. Doubt. But by default, my character is clear. My nature is very clear. It's either do or don't do. You either become an entrepreneur or you die. It's very simple, right? So I decided. So I have to do. There's nothing called not doing. Just took action. That's about it. And then, don't look at my face. I'm still handsome. Alright? This is the first product. Unmanned flying machines was the name he gave for the magazine. I was still in uniform. I'm not supposed to run a business. So I know I cannot go on record this thing. I was waiting to get married. I got married, and that's when I had all the rights to get a wife as the proprietor of the company. She was running the show. She did the whole thing. I was just the brains behind the whole thing. That's it. I was so quiet. I didn't do anything. I know it's like it's totally against the law of the land, but believe me, there is no room for an entrepreneur. I believe in this. No rules. Okay, you know, your country sets some rules you got to follow. All right, do it. Okay. But if you start following like Mahatma Gandhi, it will really take a lot of lives. He didn't die, but believe me, because of that, many people had to die. It's so simple. He didn't die. He was on the front. He was absolutely nice. Other people died because of that act. It's so very simple. So don't wait for time to come and do it. Mike, I believe in only one thing. Don't wait for success to come or anything to come, time to come, money to come. Just go grab it. It's very simple. How you go grab it is your problem. So we launched this 2011, burning all my salary. 60,000 bucks I saved that time. I don't come from a very good family financially. I had to send money to my family every month after being in the services. We have five siblings, and we were like, I'll tell you how I tell my friends who I am is, I've got one sister, younger brothers, and one younger brother. You can see where my fingers stands. I'm the bad guy. Always. I never took advice from my parents, never. Always did what I felt was correct. It's not always good to do what you feel is right, but it's okay to follow your dreams, follow your path. Whatever you feel is correct, just do it. When you're doing it, if something is going wrong, take advice. Go to the old guys. My first question to anybody who comes to advise me, did you ever run a company? Anybody come to this, I have done this, I'm director of that, I'm consultant here, you know, I've worked in Power Grid for 100 years. Then I say one question, did you ever run a company? He says no, then please don't waste your time. If you have not run a company, then you don't have any rights to give me advice. So if I have to pitch for investments, it's very simple. Those entrepreneurs who have never invested in a very minuscule level, as a startup or a project, will never be able to raise funds. So I have invested in a small company, miserably failed, invested again in partnership with another company, again failed. That's, it's okay, absolutely fine. But I learned the tricks of investors. What works, what won't work, has to be learned. That's how you do it. So I actually have to feel it. That's how I did it. So after this, 8 months, no revenues. 8 months. Printing costs about 60,000 to 70,000 bucks every month. And you need to, you know, give the designer, blah, blah, blah. My salary was about a lakh that time. So I used to send save about 20% for family and everything. 80% really was into the business. And all 80% was loss for 8 months. 8 months, and that ninth month, I don't know how it happens. You don't give up. If you give up, it's gone. My wife is saying, yeah, kya kar raha hai, we don't go for holiday, we don't go here. We're like, yeah, it's because of you only. If you're not there, I'm not here. So I had to really play that wife husband wala game. Somehow managed it. And then we went to Aero India, I was carrying full bag of magazines. Quietly giving everywhere, because Aero India is a place where all defense people come. I cannot show my face again. You cannot show, at the same time, you have to show your product. How do you do that? It's a tricky situation, right? But you have to do it. There's no way out. When you are stuck in a problem, this is Abdul Kalam's brilliant line, If you're stuck in a problem, don't hunt for a solution outside the box. See inside the box. The solution is inside the problem. It's very simple. Just find it over there, and you will get it. So we went there, did blah, 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 blah. These are the cover pages which we changed, you know, for unmanned flying machines. First was UFM. These are old pictures. Now it's unmanned. I did it, in fact. Okay, now, the thing here is, you've got to train your wife to actually do all these things. It's not possible all by her, right? She's clueless. She's a BCom graduate. She was working in ICICI Bank. A banker has got no clue what are drones. No clue what journalism. By the way, I forgot to tell you. I silently did a 6-month diploma in English journalism, not telling anybody, including the family, my bosses, anybody, because I need to learn. If I have to run a magazine, you need to learn journalism. It's not that easy. It's a 10-man hat which you're wearing. 10 different jobs you have to do. One way has to do it. So it is possible. Of course, everything is possible. And then the final day comes, 11 January 2014, I decide goodbye to Indian Navy. 10 years finished. This is the last ever picture that I took. I got it, this picture. So on that day, I leave, and then finally, I come onto the journey of entrepreneurship in full fledged. So this is what I own. Need to have a freedom of choice in whatever you want to do. Now, this is a similar situation for almost all corporate guys. It's just the difference is they were in the corporate, I was in the military. That's all. The same story, right? You can't, your corporates won't allow you to go and work anywhere else. You have to, you don't have, it's illegal. So you have to quit and then do it. So, how my routine used to be, I get up in the morning, 5 o'clock, go for a run.